7:55 a.m., Sunday morning, December 7th, 1941, Pearl Harbor near Honolulu, Hawaii. Retired U.S. Navy Lieutenant Jim Downing remembers that day as if it were yesterday.
I'd just been married for 5 months. We were having breakfast when the first bombs dropped. We turned on the radio.
And 200 miles off Hawaii, six Japanese aircraft carriers under Admiral Yamamoto had launched 353 aircraft led by Commander Mitsuo Fushida in a surprise attack against the Pacific Fleet. Jim scrambled from his house toward his ship, the USS West Virginia, berthed on Battleship Row.
So the first airplane that came my direction was all drab. I thought it was an Army plane. Then he came flying low and slow. He had machine guns. The bullets went right over my head. That's when the war became very personal.
Simultaneous air attacks were underway at six U.S. airfields. The first wave of attack along Battleship Row crippled or sunk the might of the U.S. Pacific Fleet.
We were tied up with the Oklahoma in front of us and the Arizona behind. The Oklahoma capsized and turned over. So here we were with the Oklahoma upside down in front of us, the Arizona burning like a volcano behind.
Jim first boarded the flaming deck of the USS Tennessee and slid down its 5-inch gun barrel onto the West Virginia. Massive torpedo strikes had already sunk the West Virginia into the shallow waters.
I could see the fire spreading toward the ammunition. I took a fire hose from the Tennessee and tried to cool the ammunition so it wouldn't explode because the fire was spreading to everything above the waterline.
Millions of gallons of crude oil from the USS Arizona, Oklahoma, California, and four other damaged or sinking battleships ignited the water in flames.
Oil is lighter than water, so it stayed at the top. And to see sailors being blown over the side into that oily water, sink underneath, come up, and the oil was on fire, and to see their bodies just burn like a human torch, that was the worst experience I could imagine, is seeing those human torches burning. I ran the whole gamut of emotions. The first was surprise. And then there was fear, and it turned to anger that our leadership had let us down. And then there was pride to see our man without leadership instinctively doing the right thing.
As the second wave of attacks swooped in on the USS Nevada, Jim says he felt peace while fighting the inferno.
I felt like, Lord, I'll be with you in a minute. And I fully expected to be. So I had the deepest peace I've ever felt in my life. And I think that was it. I'm going to be with you in a minute.
Jim's faith in God didn't begin in the heat of battle either.
Years earlier, aboard the West Virginia, a battleship similar to this one, Jim lived and worked alongside a group of Christian shipmates.
I was very unhappy, but Virgil was one of this group. Sing a tune, face shining, looked like he's the happiest person in the world. I knew it was Christ in him. I was attracted to Christ because of the quality of life of the guys I saw who were Christians. It was aboard the Battleship West Virginia that I gave my life to Christ because I wanted what these other people had.
Then in that crucial hour when lives were at stake, and later when his shipmates needed comfort in death, God's peace led Jim.
I knew many of them that I saw killed. We lost 108 that morning. They went down fighting. They went down trying to protect the ship and each other. I felt like everybody was a hero.
After all the fires were out, Jim rushed to the hospital. Over 3,500 Americans were dead or wounded.
My friends were burned, so I took a notebook I went down the line of these guys in suspension and said, if you give me your parents' address and dictate a note, I'll see that they get it. The main surprise was how optimistic they were. And they told their parents, don't worry about it, I'll be all right. And they knew that George M. would die that night. But I liked their optimism.
December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy.
The next day, the United States declared war on Japan.
This was going to be a long war.
Battles in the Pacific theater alone resulted in 35 million casualties, 3% of the world's population. 100,000 civilian casualties at Okinawa heavily influenced America's use of two atomic bombs against Japan to end World War II. Jim was stationed in Washington, D.C. at the war's end, grateful the 400 gunnery trainees under his command would enjoy civilian life once again.
We were relieved that it was over. We were too close to disaster. It must never happen again.
At 102 years old, Jim is the second oldest surviving veteran of the Japanese attack on Pearl Harbor.
My main admonition out of Pearl Harbor is, remember Pearl Harbor. Keep America alert and strong. Because I believe that weakness invites aggression. And we must never be weak as a nation, or aggression will result.
After Jim retired from the U.S. Navy, to his surprise, he met and befriended Japan's Pearl Harbor attack commander, Mitsuo Fushida.
I met him and talked with him on several occasions. A missionary gave Fushida a Bible, and he became a Christian and became an evangelist.
They fought against each other in war, but through Christ, discovered a brotherhood of peace.
I have a favorite verse. Ezekiel 36:23, God himself said, the nations will know me when they see me in you.